neither provided a social security number nor any other type of identification. So although our system, our statewide voter registration system allows us to do searches, it may be difficult if there's people with that, multiple people with that name, to identify the exact person, but we will make every effort to do so.
It sounds like, with regard to Registrar Lane's comment, that if he doesn't appear on the 3rd and we take some type of action, if he showed up to vote thereafter, it would be a provisional ballot and we'd still have the opportunity to verify.
Yes, absolutely. Thank you for following up on that. That's absolutely the case. If he showed up to the polls on election day and asked for a ballot, his name, we would, the warden at the polls would contact the town clerk and the board of registrars if you're in the elections office, ask for you to do the research. The research that you would do would show that he had been on the list within the last 3 years, and therefore, at that point, there would be the opportunity to immediately call for a hearing. Under Chapter 41, Section, 51, Section 49, it says that we have to give the same notice. So, I believe, how many days after a state election? 10 days to do the verifications?
Yes, 10
days. Yeah, there's 10 days to check on provisional voters. So we would have certainly a sufficient amount of time to do the notice, to provide service, do the notice, and hold the hearing.
So if he doesn't make it by the 3rd, it still doesn't deny him the right to vote. We would have to do the checking.
That's right.
Okay. Any other questions or discussion?
Absolutely.
At this point, I would open the floor up for a motion for a finding of probable cause. Anybody wish to make that motion?
I'd like to make a motion that we instruct the town clerk to proceed with as listed on the agenda to consider whether to proceed with accordance with General Law Chapter 51, Subsection 47B, 48, and 49. To issue a summons and schedule a hearing with respect to a voter registration affidavit filed by Emmanuel Cortez Jr. And if a decision is made to so proceed, to authorize the town clerk to issue said summons and to take such additional action as is needed to call for and hold such hearing.
And that would be predicated on a finding of probable cause by the three of us. Is that fair to say as part of your motion?
Yes.
Mr. Chairman, may I add one more piece to that?
Yes.
Based upon, I think we could say based upon issues with the face of the affidavit and also the acknowledgement notice being sent to the address where current residents.
That being the evidence of the probable cause.
Yes.
Second. Any further discussion? All in favor?
Aye.
It's unanimous.